I'm Naomi Lewin. Welcome to Classics for Kids. You hear all the time about fathers who, from the time their daughters are very young, work hard to turn them into sports stars. But before Clara Schumann was even born, her father decided that his child was going to be a famous pianist. Clara Wieck was born in 1819 in the German city of Leipzig, where her father, Friedrich Wieck, was a famous piano teacher. Clara's mother was a musician too, a singer and pianist who took lessons with and then married her piano teacher, namely Clara's father. But the marriage didn't last long. After the divorce, German law gave custody of Clara to her father, and Friedrich Wieck set about turning his daughter into a musical prodigy. In addition to studying piano with her father, Clara Wieck took violin, composition, and lessons in all kinds of other musical subjects from all the best teachers in town. And she learned about running the business end of a career. Clara first played in public when she was 9. At 11, she gave her first solo recital, a concert all by herself. As a teenager, Clara Wieck toured all over Europe. Back then, pianists mostly played flashy pieces that they had written specifically to show off. But Clara Wieck included music by other composers on her concerts, Bach, Beethoven, and Schubert, plus newcomers like Chopin. She was known as the Queen of the Piano and considered the equal of the best male performers. The Austrian emperor was so impressed with her playing that he made her the first female royal and imperial chamber virtuoso, a high honor given only to the best musicians. When Clara Wieck was 13, she started writing a piano concerto and got help with it from another one of her father's students, Robert Schumann. Even though Friedrich Wieck had controlled every step of his daughter's career up until then, he couldn't control her love life, even though he tried. Clara and Robert Schumann fell in love, and when she was 18, they wanted to get married. Her father did everything he could to stop them. But eventually, love triumphed over all. Robert and Clara Schumann had a wonderful musical partnership. They studied music and poetry together and gave each other composing advice. Clara Schumann played the first performance of everything Robert wrote for the piano. Through her concerts, she introduced his music all over Europe, everywhere from England to Russia. And talk about a super mom! Clara Schumann had 8 children and ran a household while continuing to perform and compose. During the course of their marriage, Robert Schumann got very sick. At first, Clara steered him towards new jobs she thought might help him recover from his mental illness. But eventually, he needed expensive medical care, and Clara was the one who went out on tour to play concerts to support the family. Right before Robert had to go into the hospital, a young composer turned up on the Schumanns' doorstep with a letter of introduction from a musical friend of theirs. Johannes Brahms became a good friend of the family and helped Clara out while Robert was sick. Brahms and Clara Schumann wound up spending a lot of time together. No one is quite sure if they were in love with each other or not. But when Robert Schumann died, they didn't get married. Clara Schumann stopped composing then, but she continued to perform. Her remarkable concert career lasted 60 years. I'm Naomi Lewin. I write Classics for Kids and produce it with Tim Lanter at WGUC Cincinnati. Please join me next week to hear about famous musical families on Classics for Kids.